So today we are going to see some symbols which we are going to use in our circuits of hydraulics and pneumatics. Okay, so let's we are starting from the pump. So how we show pump? For this pump, we are having symbol like this. So this is the symbol for pump. Symbol of fixed displacement. As you know that this pump is used to pump the fluid. That's why this inner triangle is always filled like this. You have to fill that inner triangle, then it's become hydraulic pump. Okay, because the fluidity which is going to be pulled or pushed by this pump is visible. That's why we are going to fill this triangle here. Okay, then another is then if we put arrow in this, then it becomes variable displacement pump. Okay, and if we want to make it as pressure compensated pump, then we have to add some another equipment in this. Now this is the symbol for pressure compensated pump. What is the meaning of this pressure compensated pump? When we want to adjust the pressure by using this valve, then at this time we are using this pressure compensated pump. This is the pump having facility to compensate. Means compensate means to increase or reduce the pump. Okay, again we are going to see the symbol of bidirection pump. So for this bidirection pump, the symbol is like this. We are going to draw this bidirectional pump. Bidirectional pump means the pump can force or push the fluid in both upward and downward direction, then it becomes bidirectional pump. Again, this is the pump pumping the fluid. That's why this triangle is also filled like this shape here. So this becomes bidirectional pump. This is the symbol for bidirectional pump here. Okay, now we are going to see another symbol, which is air compressor. So to draw the symbol of air compressor. So air compressor symbol is quite similar with the pump. See the symbol here. There is only a single difference between the hydraulic pump and air compressor, which is that only this part is remained to be unfilled here in this triangle. The triangle which we are going to be filled in this pump. Like this, we are not going to fill here because it is a pump. In an air compressor, air is invisible. That's why this part is not filled here. But in case of pump, the liquid is visible. So we are highlighting the triangle here in case of pump, and we are not highlighting the compressor here. The triangle here because air compressor compresses the air which is invisible one. Okay. Now we are going to see some types of cylinder. So here we go to see the types of cylinder. You know what is cylinder? What is a cylinder? It is having outer covering, then piston and connecting rod here. Okay. So this is our piston and cylinder combining. So if there is an entry of liquid, it is only in one direction. Okay, there is only liquid entering in this through only this one direction. That's why it is called as a single acting cylinder. What is the name of this? Name of this symbol is single acting cylinder. Why it is single acting cylinder? Because there is entry of fluid only in one direction. The pressurized liquid which is coming from the pump lies only in this direction, one direction of this piston. That's why it is called as single acting cylinder. Then what is in double acting cylinder? In double acting cylinder, the liquid lies on both the sides. Stop making annotations. If there are two ports and liquid comes and goes out from these two directions, then it is called as double acting cylinder. These arrows are shown for the learning purpose only. In final exam, you just have to draw these two horizontal lines. These two lines shows the ports, and liquid lies in both side of the piston. That's why it becomes double acting cylinder. Okay. Now we are going to see single acting cylinder spring return. Okay. Now we are going to study the symbol for single acting spring return cylinder. So for this single acting means the fluid is coming from this one direction only, and spring return means we are going to connect a spring here to this piston. That's why the return action or extract action is coming from coming by this spring here. So this is the spring. So return action of this is done by this spring here. That's why it is named as single acting spring return cylinder. You know, in double acting cylinder we are going to connect a separate line here. That's why it becomes double acting. But in this case it is single acting and spring return. So that return action is done by this spring here. Okay. Now we are going to see the next symbol, which is double rod cylinder. So what is double rod cylinder? Double rod cylinder is like this. You know, in last section I told you that suppose there is a pipeline like this. And you are going to control its opening and closing by connecting this valve to this connecting rod of this piston. So, and similarly, suppose there are two pipelines on both the direction. And you are going to control the valves of opening and closing by this piston cylinder. So at this time we are going, if there are the doni bajula jar pipeline asel ani aplyala doni action simultaneously perform karayche asel, ek open ek close kiwa ek close and dusra open simultaneously aplyala jar perform karayche asel tar tya velala apan kay use karu, apan use karu double acting डबल रॉड सिलिंडर. बघा याचं नाव काय आता, डबल रॉड सिलिंडर. ओके, आता हे आपण अझम्पशन साठी ड्रॉ केलेलं, बट द ऍक्च्युअल सिम्बॉल फक्त एवढंच. Why we are going to use this double acting double rod cylinder to control the two pipelines simultaneously, but its symbol is like this only. Okay, now we are going to see hydraulic motor symbols. We are going to see now hydraulic motor symbol. Where you see hydraulic motor, I already told you in the while drawing this hydraulic circuit that this hydraulic motor is connected to the pump. This motor is used to run the pump. So now here are some symbols for this hydraulic motor. So again we are going to draw. What is the name of the symbol? Name of the symbol is fixed displacement unidirection. Unidirectional what? Unidirectional motor. And what is the difference between the symbol of this pump and What is difference in symbol of this pump and motor? The only difference is this triangle here. This triangle is inverted in case of motor, and this triangle is regular or simple one in case of pump. Again, this is the symbol for hydraulic motor. That's why we are going to fill the triangle here, because this is going to handle the fluid. That's why this fluid is visible. So we are going to make this shadow here in triangle. Okay, now we are going to see another symbol of this hydraulic motor, which is fixed displacement bidirectional. Fixed displacement by directional. And this is the bidirectional. Then again, we are going to add this triangle here. This triangle are again inverted because this is motor, and this triangle are simple in case of pump. And this is bidirectional. That's why we are going to draw this triangle in this type here. And again, we are going to handle this hydraulic fluid. That's why this triangle should be shaded like this. Okay, again, we are going to see variable displacement bidirectional. So for variable displacement, or variable displacement bidirectional pump, only this symbol of this arrow is get added here. Now this becomes symbols for variable displacement bidirectional pump. Okay. Now we are going to see some another symbols of pneumatic motor symbol. So this is the symbol for hydraulic motor. And what will be the symbol for pneumatic motor? Symbol for pneumatic motor. I already shows you, while there is a difference in hydraulic and pneumatic, only that we are going to change this shade in that triangle here. So if you remove that shading here, then it becomes pneumatic motor. Okay, now we are going to draw this fixed displacement unidirectional pneumatic motor. At that time, we are not going to fill this triangle because this is pneumatic motor and handling air only. Who is that making annotation? Stop doing silly things. Okay, again we are going to see some symbols of control valves. So that's why I am again sharing screen here. So this becomes symbol of fixed displacement, unidirectional, pneumatic motor. And again, which is, what is this? This is unidirectional. Again, if we see the fixed displacement bidirection, then only this this part of this we need to be removed. Only in case of pump, we need to draw the motor here. Fix displacement. Bidirectional motor. Which kind is this? Pneumatic. Okay, now we are going to see some again another symbols of flow control valve and flow control region. We are going to see the symbol for air dryer. Why we are going to use air dryer in pneumatic system? Because if air contains some water particles along with it, then it causes problem of corrosion or rusting inside the compressor. That's why we are using this air dryer to dry the complete air. Because if water droplets are present along with the air, then they condensate inside the compressor and causes the problem of corrosion inside the compressor. Okay, to eliminate this, we are going to use this air dryer here. Then what is this lubricator? So again, the symbol for lubricator is like this. So what is lubricator? Lubricator, it is a device which is just adds some oil with the moving air or flowing air. What is the reason of adding this oil? Because the addition of this oil makes the air smooth. This air does not directly compact or collapse on the wall of this compressor. They become smooth. That's why we are using this lubricator here. Okay, if this meeting stopped because of the time limit of Zoom app, then I am share this link, attendance link on your WhatsApp group. Okay, so whenever the system this time lapse, then the meeting will be end there. Okay, now we are going to see another symbol, which is FRL. So what is the full form of this FRL? It is combined name of filter then regulator and lubricator. FRL, it is the complete assembly of these three parts: filter, regulator and lubricator. So what is the symbol of this? The symbol of FRL is like this. Okay, so first part is filter. Then what is the symbol for filter? The symbol for filter is like this in FRL. Okay, then another is regulator. So symbol which we are going to use for regulator is like this. And the third one is the lubricator. I already explained this filter and regulator. Okay, so what is the function of filter? The function of filter is to remove any foreign material which is coming with the air while compressor absorbs the air. Okay. And what is the function of regulator? The function of regulator is to regulate the pressure of air inside the compressor. And what is the function of lubricator? The function of lubricator is to add some lubricated oil in the flowing air. Okay. So again, some another symbol. Symbol for silencer. You know what is silencer? Silencer is used to make the system quiet. Because you know, while working with the pneumatic system, there is a sound of air flow can be causes, and which is irritating one. To eliminate this sound, we are going to use the silencer. And symbol for silencer is like this. The function of silencer is to make operation of this system quiet one, or make the system noiseless. We are going to use the silencer. Okay, this is the symbol for silencer. Now we are going to see the symbols for direction control valves. Symbols of direction control valves. Look, student, after 5 minutes the meeting will be stopped. So don't be panic. Just give your attendance on WhatsApp group, link in the WhatsApp group, and we will continue until the meeting stop. So direction control valves are used to control the direction of moving fluid. How we are going to control this direction, why it is used, is already explained in the previous lessons or previous lectures. So here we are going to explain the symbols only. Okay, so we are going to draw here 2x2 direction control valve. Direction control valve. Then what is the meaning of this 2x2? Meaning of these two, first two is they are the weights. Two weights. And meaning of another two is the meaning of another two is it is two position. Okay, so how we are going to draw this symbol of this 2x2 direction control wall? Like this. See here, this is the this is position 1 and this is position 2. So okay, this is two position wall. And what about this ways? How we are going to show this ways? I am showing here. Just listen. You can see in every position there are just two ways. This is the first way. You can see this is the first way and this is second way, or you can say there are these two ports. This is the first port and this is second port. This is the first port and this is second port. What you can say, this is the first way and this is the second way to come inside this position. This is the first way and this is the second way. One way is to come and second way is to go out. That's why there are two ways in every each position. That's why the name of this wall is 2x2 wall. Two way and two position. Okay, let's